Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
So hello and good morning students. Let's see the next topic, absolute and relative velocity. It's a pretty simple topic to understand. I'll talk about the topic in detail. Let's see. So absolute velocity is nothing but, I'll directly start off with a definition. Absolute velocity is nothing but the velocity of any point or any object with respect to a fixed point. I'll give an example to make you understand this. Suppose I'm standing at a platform and the train is moving. I'm stationary. So the velocity of train with respect to me is absolute velocity. So that's how it is. Now, relative velocity is nothing but the velocity of any object or any point with respect to a moving point or a moving object. Suppose two trains are moving and the velocity of the first train with respect to the second train is nothing but the relative velocity of train 1 with respect to train 2. So that is how it works. Now, when we talk about links, when we talk about mechanisms, when we study TOM, we cannot talk in terms of trains or something. We have to talk in terms of links. So let's try and understand with the in a single slider crank chain or in a 4-bar chain how the velocity absolute and relative velocity of different points will be. So as you can see, I've drawn a 4-bar chain. The bottom link is fixed. Now we'll name them. So AB, BC, CD and AD, these are the four links. The link AD is fixed. Now the input is given to the crank. The shortest link is considered as crank. The input is given generally to the shortest link. So let's assume that AB is the crank and the motion is given to link AB. Now, as you can see here, you have two points fixed, that is A and D. These two are the fixed points, whereas B and C, these points are moving. When you assume that the 4-bar chain is in motion, you'll see that point A and D will be stationary all the time and B and C will be moving here and there. So B and C are moving points, A and D are fixed points. So velocity will always be connected with a moving point. A stationary point cannot have any velocity. So the velocity will be of velocity of B and velocity of C. Now velocity of B with respect to A will be absolute velocity because A is fixed. As I said earlier, absolute velocity is nothing but velocity of any point with respect to a fixed point. So since A is fixed, velocity of B with respect to A will be absolute velocity of A. And how do you write it? So VBA means velocity of point B with respect to point A. And this is how you write it. VBA. The first alphabet indicates velocity of the point and the second alphabet indicates with respect to which point. So B with respect to A is nothing but velocity of point B with respect to A. And it is absolute velocity because point A is fixed. Now if you see velocity, now let's go on to point C. Velocity of point C with respect to D. So since D is a fixed point, and as I said earlier, velocity of any point with respect to a fixed point is nothing but absolute velocity. So velocity of C with respect to D will be absolute velocity. So VCD means velocity of C with respect to D. This is how you read it, and it means absolute velocity because point D is fixed. So we've seen absolute velocities. Now let's talk about relative velocity. So if you see velocity of point C with respect to point B, since both the points are moving, velocity of C with respect to B will be a relative velocity. As you can see here, both C and B will be in motion, they are not stationary. So velocity of C with respect to D is a relative velocity. So this is how absolute and relative velocity works in case of Tom, in case of links. So you have to be aware what VBA means, what VCD means, what VCB means. So you have to see if there is any point fixed, so you can say that it is a velocity of B with respect to A is absolute. If both the points are moving, and if I'm measuring velocity of C with respect to B and both the points are moving, I call it relative velocity. So that was all about this topic, absolute and relative velocity. I hope you've understood this, and this concept will be using further in our numericals also. Thank you.